Hello everyone, and welcome to a Clip Studio Paint beginner course on digital illustration. Today we're going to draw a simple character illustration using the basic functions of Clip Studio Paint. We recommend this for those who want to draw digitally with a soft traditional style as if drawing on paper. Let's begin! First, let's create a canvas to draw on. Tap New from the command bar. Then set the Use of Work to Illustration and enter 2000 for both the width and height. Now, tap OK in the upper right corner to create a square canvas. Layers are used to create art in digital drawing software. A layer is similar to a transparent piece of film. All lines and colors are drawn on these transparent layers. Press the icon on the left side of the screen to open the layer palette. There are two layers, the paper layer and layer 1. For this illustration, we'll add two more layers, one for drawing line art and one for applying color. Tap New Raster Layer on the top of the layer palette to add a layer. Let's rename each layer to something that is easy to understand for its role. Double tapping the layer name will allow you to rename it. The layer order from the top to bottom is line art, color, sketch, paper. You can reorder layers by long pressing the grip on the right side of each one and dragging. Select the pencil tool from the tool palette. Select the pencil subtool from the subtool palette. The pencil subtool in Clip Studio Paint changes in size and density depending on the pen pressure. You can also tilt the stylus to draw broad strokes, just like a real pencil. You can change the color of the pencil by tapping the black tile in the Color Set palette, where standard colors are registered. For the sketch, we'll start with rough shapes and then gradually add details. The eraser tool is located in the tool palette. Select the eraser icon in the tool palette and use it to erase as needed. Be careful to keep the character's head and body proportions in balance. The girl has a 1-to-1 head-to-body size ratio. Once the shapes are prominent enough that they will not get lost in the line art, the sketch is complete. We'll modify the layer settings to make it easier to draw the line art. Show the layer property palette and tap the Change Layer Color button. This changes the color of the sketch from black to light blue. Next, open the layer palette and shift the opacity slider in the upper right corner to the left. Now we can still see the sketch while drawing the line art. Select the line art layer. Here we'll draw our line art. Since we want the illustration to look soft, we'll use the same pencil tool as in the sketch. The trick to line art is to rotate the canvas in a direction that makes it easier to draw each line. With two fingers, tap and hold to rotate and adjust the angle of the canvas. To redraw a line, we'll use Undo. Tap with two fingers on the canvas to undo the last line drawn. Once your line art is complete, we'll hide the sketch layer. Open the layer palette and tap the eye icon on the left side of the sketch layer. Our line art is now complete. If you want sharper looking lines, use the pen tool instead to draw. Display the subtool palette and select the felt pen subtool from the marker group. We'll be using the felt pen to draw, just as we did with the pencil, using the eraser and the two-finger tap to undo as needed. Before we start applying color, let's add a paper-like texture to the canvas. First, we'll change the paper layer to a warm color. Double-tap the thumbnail of the paper layer in the layer palette to open the color settings dialog. Make the hue closer to orange and choose a bright cream color in the upper left of the color space. Then press OK in the upper right corner to change the canvas color. Next, apply the texture. Tap the material palette icon in the lower left corner of the screen. The material palette contains useful materials that can be used for illustrations. Here we'll select a texture and paste it to the canvas. After opening the material palette, select Medium Textured from Texture under Monochromatic Pattern and drag and drop it onto the canvas. This adds a new layer to the layer palette called Medium Textured. If the medium textured layer is not created at the top of the layer palette, drag it to the top. By placing it on top, you can add texture to all the layers below. Then, with the medium texture layer selected, open the Layer Property palette and tap the Overlay Texture button. Your canvas will now have a paper-like texture to it. Now, let's begin coloring. Show the layer palette and tap the color layer. Now, let's select a brush to apply color. Tap the Brush tool in the tool palette and then the Brush Subtool icon. The Brush tool has three main groups: watercolor, thick paint, and India ink, each containing different types of subtools. We will use the round mixing brush from the thick paint group. This group contains brushes that can be used to blend colors. Brush thickness can be adjusted with the brush size palette. Display the color wheel palette, adjust the hue and brightness, and you're ready to go! The density of the round mixing brush depends on the pen pressure. Change the color and brush size according to where you are painting. Fix mistakes and overflows with the eraser tool or the two-finger tap. In addition to the eraser, you can also use the transparent color that can be selected from the tool palette to correct the image. If the brush's color is set as transparent, you can draw strokes that erase the color like an eraser. Displaying the Color History palette allows you to reselect any of the colors you have previously used. For areas you want to add color, such as patterns, paint the base color with the round mixing brush, and then draw in the details on top with the pencil. And now the color is finished. Lastly, we'll change the color of the line art. Let's pick a brown color so the line art blends in and creates a soft impression. Select the line art layer in the layer palette. Then open the layer property palette. Tap layer color in the layer property palette to change the color of the line art to blue. To change the color used for the layer color, tap the color bar next to layer color. In the color settings dialog, pick a brown color and tap OK to change the color of the line art. The illustration is now complete. Once your work is complete, you can share it immediately. Tap the File menu, Quick Share, and then select the social media or messaging app you wish to share it to. Try sharing it with your friends and family.
Clip Studio Paint.